Look, I am Shraddha here. So today I will be covering other parts of digital marketing that I discussed in my first video. So today I will be covering around 4 to 5 topics, and it is not going to so long video. It will be a short video because I want you to revise whatever topics I have covered so far, that is in my first video and in my second video. So today I will be covering around 5 to 6 more topics, and I covered around 7 to 8 topics in the first video. So it's good if you are maintaining notes and you are writing definition of each of these topics and you are understanding these topics. And if there is any kind of doubt, just let me know. I will be resolving your doubts and will be coming up with examples to clear up your doubts. So let's start with today's topic. Today I am going to cover social media platforms, new age marketing, then various tools. No, tools is like it's another topic that will cover various kind of other topics. Like if I talk about content curation, so there would be around 4 to 5 tools, and then graphic designing, then again there would be some tools, and for analytics of marketing or to check the performance, so there are 4 to 5 tools to maintain social media post from one platform. So there are again like other set of tools. So I will be covering marketing tools in in one video, because it is going to a big topic, and around 50 to 100 tools would be there. So you need to decide what are some of the tools, say one or two, that you will be using for various purposes, like while doing marketing. So let's start with social media platforms. So when it comes to digital marketing, so social media platform has become one of the most important places where we can do marketing even for free. And if we want some set of impression, or say if you want a big audience of 1 lakh or 2 lakh, then you can spend some money to get expected audience that you wanted, like for your campaign or for your product. So if I talk about social media platforms, so platforms would be Quora, LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, and then Twitter. Twitter is like microblogging. You can write three to four sentences with proper hashtags or proper tagging of like some relevant person related to your post. So you need not to, or you can't write a big article there. You can't post big photos there. So it would be good if you are using Twitter for microblogging. And when it comes to LinkedIn, so you can use LinkedIn for some professional work. Say if you are doing some process, or say if you have your own story or a struggle story based on your product or your company, so you can share it in LinkedIn by also sharing your company's page or your company's website, or maybe your conversion link or your landing page, so that if I am liking your story, then maybe I will be looking for some of your products, and if I like your product, so I can place the order to get your product and to use it. So it would be great, like whenever you are posting something, just make sure that you are writing or you are mentioning some kind of call to action there, because if I am I am paying attention for your stuff or for your article, say for your product, so you should add something that if I am reading it, so I can make you, or I can help you in gaining some kind of profit. So you can get something out of each and every impression people are giving on your post or on your articles. So yes, if you are sharing something, or if you are sharing one article or say one infographic, then it's good if you are mentioning. If you want to increase your followers in your company space, then you can add the LinkedIn profile link or LinkedIn page link. Or if you want to increase the conversion rate, then you can add the landing page of your company's website. So there are different purposes to add call to action. So based on that, or whatever result you want, so you can do the same, and then you can add the same call to action in whatever article you are writing. Now it was about LinkedIn. when it comes to Quora, so Quora is something like a great way to create awareness about your product. So here what you can do, you can just go through the questions related to your work. Say if you are in IT sector, so you can write like, what are some of the top active companies, or say active companies in Bangalore based on IT sector. So if you are getting this, like if you are seeing this, or you are searching for this question, once you get it, just start writing about your, firstly you can write about what is IIT sector, then you can mention some products, and then you can write about your company's detail so that people can get to know about your company. And Quora is also a great place to create a space based on your company's, like company's profile. So as I have worked for whatever companies I work for, so I used to, like there are around 2 to 3 companies where I was highly dedicated for Quora work. Say one company was Growth Marts, and then there were other set of CET, and then other set of companies were also there. So if you are working for these companies and you are maintaining Quora space or Quora page for it, so you should be active enough by post or say by answering questions on a consistent basis, because this consistency will be helpful for your company to get ranked on Google. So if someone is searching for your company's profile, so your Quora answers or say your Quora profile will start ranking on Google without paying anything. You need not to maintain a highly profile, or you need not to maintain run some kind of advertisement to get ranked on Google. But if you are maintaining your Quora profile on a daily basis, you are answering there, you are posting some relevant stuff there, you have around 50 to 100 followers, but you are active enough, you are posting on a daily basis, so your profile can get ranked on Google. So if I'm searching something about based on your area of work, so if I'm getting about your company, so I will be visiting your website, I will be understanding your work, and if I will be interested in your product, then I will be placing the order. So that's something based on various social media apps. Like in Quora, if I talk about Quora, so on Quora what you can do, you can write answers, you can search for questions, you can even ask questions, and then you can share your answers and your stuff or your space post on various other posts. You can follow relevant post or relevant spaces based on your company sector. And then if I talk about Instagram, so what you can do, you can use proper hashtagging. And the main, when I talk about Instagram, so I would suggest you to use meme tactics, because whenever I have created memes for a company, so they used to get great attention. Like if there are around 50 to 60 posts, and if I have posted 4 to 5 memes, so the highest number of likes or engagement, rate of engagement would be there in memes. So you can also use the same. So yeah, there are some other platforms also like Etsy, Pinterest, which you can use for the betterment of your company. But I think what I believe in, you should cover only 5 to 6 or say 7 platforms. Say LinkedIn, Quora, Instagram, Facebook. And then these are 4, Twitter. I think these 5 to 6 platforms are enough. And if you are focusing on these platforms on a daily basis, and you are doing something, or you are making post, you are sharing something, you are sharing one article, you are sharing one story or your journey on a daily basis in this platform, so that would be fine. You need not to create your account on each and every platforms. What you can do, you can use Medium, or you can create a blog website on WordPress or say Wix.com for your company, where you can share some topics, where you can cover some topics. And once you are done with explaining these topics, what you can do in the end of the article, you can share about your company's work. So doing this, you can get you can again get good attention. And don't forget to add landing page or whatever CTA, that is call to action, you want for your company. Like if I am reading your blog post, so you are making me to read that blog post because you have something or you have some intentions that you want me to do. If you want me to buy a product, so add that product link so that once I am done with getting the feature or reading the feature about your product, it should not go worthless. Like I am reading it, I found it very great, but I am unable to find the link, so I am not able to place the order. So you should also add the link. So whatever your intention is to write a blog, so you should add the link or you should add your company's website to create the awareness or something like that. So make a note of these things too, because these are the small things but make a big difference when it comes to marketing. So next thing is, I would say that no one earns a good reputation or no one earns a lot of money or no one earns success within a night. So you have to wait for it. Maybe it is going to take 1 month, 2 months, 6 months or a year, but you should be consistent enough. You should not stop working on the work that you have started to work with. So just be consistent on it, make posts. And it would be great if you have one team, say writer team or graphic designer team, and that's great if you know all these things, so that you need not to get help from anyone else, if especially when you are running a startup, like you have just started working for your idea or for your business. So yeah, and next is now new age marketing. So new age marketing is again one of the great thing. If I talk about LinkedIn, so what LinkedIn has done, they have being a user of LinkedIn, what I can do, I can make a short video of mine and I can put it in my profile picture as a cover story. So if I am looking for a job, so what I can do, I can just make a small video that I am actively looking for an opportunity, and I have digital marketing, writing, Quora marketing and graphic designing skills. If you have any kind of post based on these skills, just let me know and you can find me my resume in my profile. So I can make one small video based on this thing, and if someone is visiting my profile, so they can easily get to understand that yes, I am looking for an opportunity, and if there is any such opportunity in their business, so they will be approaching me. So that's a great way if I talk about LinkedIn opportunities for users or for those who are looking for various job opportunities. So similarly, there are various other ways to do marketing. Say podcasting is one of such ways, then webinars, then live streaming and all these things, then or doing collaboration with someone else, going live with some other marketers or some other businessmen, conducting sessions or participation events, and where you can also ask questions and you can discuss about your business and all such kind of. You can also make videos, you can put it on YouTube and also in other platforms where you can, there are a lot of such platforms where you can make videos. You can talk about business, you can get attention from outside, and yes, you can do good. So these are some of the great new tactics that has come within these 2 to 3 years in the field of marketing. So I would appreciate these tactics, because this is something where you have to say whatever you want to tell about your company. If I am writing something, so I can't write each and everything there. If I am talking to you over a text, so maybe I won't be able to explain things more clearly. But if you are talking to me over a phone call, so I will be making things more clear. So if you are getting one opportunity to make a video and share with your audience, so it would be a great way to discuss your product in detail. So if there is any such opportunity, you should take benefit of it and you should do the same as per the marketing trends or what your competitors are doing. So yes, this would be great if you are also doing this for your business. Next is influencer marketing. So you must have seen that whenever we use Instagram, so what we see there are a lot of influencers on Instagram. They used to make videos on beauty product. They used to promote some like new product that maybe उन्होंने use भी ना किया. So like we can learn something from these videos that how to promote it. We can learn from them to how to do it, and then we can again use these tactics for our business, and we can also do it for our products. So what they used to do, they just used to collaborate or do paid partnership with any company, and then they used to promote it on various social media apps. So you can also connect with various influencers related to your field. So if you are in digital marketing, so you can connect with various writers with good number of followers on social media apps or social media platforms. And once they get they are ready to do collaboration with you, you can ask them to promote your product, and with some, maybe you have to pay something because they are not going to do something for free. So just pay some amount, and if they really have good audience or good number of people or followers, then your product can reach out to many people that you were finding difficult to like make shout out, or that when you were doing marketing, so people were not going or were not getting to know too much about your product. So if you are using influencer marketing on various platforms, I won't say that you should limit yourself on Instagram only, but also you can see some other influencer on Facebook or say Quora, or yeah, LinkedIn is also another like great platform where you can get great number of like influencer on LinkedIn with good number of followers. Followers should be at least 5,000 to 10,000. And then if there are more number of followers, like based on the number that I have told you, like 5,000 to 10,000, there are more number of followers, then it would be great because you can really get great attention. And one more thing is that LinkedIn has a capability to reach around millions of people, because I have personally experienced it. I have written some articles and it has crossed like millions of viewers. So you can also do it for your business. And if content is strong and the way the influencer is putting your content or sharing it, so if it is doing it in perfect manner, then it can get great attention. I am not saying that when you will share your first post, it will reach out to millions of people. No. But you have to do it on a consistent basis. Say you are posting 2 posts, 3 posts, 5 posts, 10 posts. But like among these 10 posts, there would be some posts that will get great number of reach. So there is no harm to try new marketing strategies, because once you will get to understand what kind of marketing is working for your company, you can continue with the same marketing with some other additional like tactics. So yeah, that's it. That's about influencer marketing. Now I will talk about pricing strategy. Okay, so other topics I will take in my next session. So today's last topic is pricing strategy. So when we go in marketing a market, so what people used to understand, like what they used to do, they get confused about the cost price that they should put for their product. So if I am making one product and I have spent around 500 to 1000 rupees, but I am like planning to sell that product in 100 or 200 rupees, so it would be a loss for me, straight 300 rupees loss. And I'm not here to get loss, or I'm not here to like incur loss for my business. I am here to earn profit. I am here to grow on a daily basis, or on a monthly basis, or on an annually basis. So to do it, I should think practically that if I am spending 500 rupees, then I should get at least 510 or 500, 600 or 700, whatever like ROI I want from my product. So for that matter, there are around 3 to 4 kinds of costing or pricing. That is, first is demand based pricing. So if demand is too much and people are like they just want product, they are ready to pay any cost, so you can just increase the price of your product because people are there to buy it. When I talk about sanitizer, when I talk about mask during 2020, so people were ready to pay any amount or for remdesivir, and there are a lot of such criteria where people were like freely, where people like, there was, when they talk about life, so it was more important. So a human life was more important than whatever money we are concerning about. So there comes a time when there would be a set of product for which I am ready to pay anything. I just want that product. So based on that demand, or if demand is low, so you can reduce the price, but if demand is high, so you can increase the price. So understand the strategy based on the demand, and then you can set your price for your product. So first is demand based pricing, then competition based pricing. If your competition is like selling something at high rate, so what you can do, you can enter in the market, in the same market you can decrease some level of price, or you can like after decreasing price you can do better than your competitor, because he's also or she's also providing the same product with quality and features, but you are here, you are giving the same product with less price, so people will be attracted towards your product. Next is penetration marketing. Penetration marketing is one of the great example, one of the great way to get into the market when you are very new in the market. If I talk about Jio, so what Jio did, they came up with like almost negligible prices. They just came up in the market, they shared a lot of schemes that it would be free, 1500 rupees mobile phone, 4G and all these things, SIM will be free, you need not to pay anything and all these things. People were willingly started buying the SIM, they were started buying the phones, and they started using it. But once they got penetrated into the market, what they did, they just started increasing or raising their price. And as they were providing good services, so people didn't stop buying their product. Once they start rising it, people were still like buying their product. Maybe there might be some decrement of number of users, but it was still doing good. So it is also one of the great way, that is penetration marketing is also a great way to get into the market, and based on your competition, like it's also part of competition based pricing. So now next one is, next is when I talk about, so there comes other strategies or other kind of pricing. So it comes under like going rate pricing, whatever rate is there, so I will be putting the price on the same basis. Then pricing, bundling marketing or bundling pricing. Say if I am selling one piece, so I will be bundle it with one toothbrush and I will be selling it. And with, I will be increasing some price. So if a toothpaste is costing 50 rupees, but if a brush is costing 30 or 40 rupees separately, I am bundling it and I am selling this like that bundle of product in 70 rupees. So people will be loving to buy that product, because the thing that they were getting in 80, 90 rupees, now they are getting the same thing in 70 rupees. So they will do it. So these are also some of the great ways to do marketing or to set the prices in marketing. So that's it for today. In my next video I will be coming up with around 7 to 8 topics, because I am trying to cover as many as topic in one video. But if I am I will be started covering 10 to 15 topics in one video, so it would be a kind of like something confusing, or some kind of a lot of confusion would be there, so you won't be able to understand the topics in a clear manner. So I will be covering around 6 to 7 or say 8 topics in one video. So stay tuned and keep watching this, and it would be great if you are maintaining your notes. And if you have any kind of doubts, just let me know. I will try to share more like examples based on whatever theory I'm sharing. And once I will be done with theory part, I will be started sharing videos on the practicals. Like I will be sharing my screen with proper how to run campaign, what are the marketing tools, how to use it, what is graphic designing. If you are not a writer, then how you can do a small like write up, how you can write a small write up for your company, how you can manage it, what are the ways to get like understand the hashtags. And then how to get ranked on Google, what are some of the main things that you should take care of, and yeah, various such, there are a lot of such things. So maybe this like digital marketing classes will take a lot number of videos, say 40, it may be 30, 40 or 50, but I will be covering each and every topic, and I will also include Quora marketing, because there are no books where Quora marketing is there in marketing, but it has already a part of a marketing subject. So I will be sharing about Quora marketing too, so that you can upgrade your knowledge about marketing and you can understand it in a clear manner. So yes, that's it for today. If you have liked this video, please like, subscribe, share and comment in case you have any kind of doubts, and I will be meeting soon in my next video. Till then, see ya, and yes, try to understand these videos in a clear manner, and if you have any problem, just let me know, and we'll be meeting soon. Yeah, bye.